As I watched Wakanda Forever, I had a moment during the opening titles where I recognized the great convenience of crafting text animations in Blender using String Node that we have now in Blender 3D. Now you are able to create these text animations procedurally without disrupting the animation flow. This means you can now try out different fonts, designs without causing any issues. Now it's a really handy feature. You can even build and keep a whole library of these animations and repurpose those later. So if you're someone who enjoys making simple titles, idents, and has a general interest in 3D typography, then stick around and let's create this interesting titles from Wakanda Forever. So this is Ram from CrossMind Studio. Welcome back to another exciting chapter. So let's jump to Blender. I'm using Blender 3.6. I'm going to split this window so that we can bring a geometry node editor. So now that we have clean space, let's bring a simple plane at the center. Create a new node network, geometry node network on this one. I'm going to disconnect it anyway because we won't be needing the original plane. So you can delete the group input. Now let's bring a string node from the search. And here I'm going to write the title that we are trying to recreate from the movie. Now to render this string, we are going to need to convert this into a curve object. So if you type string to curves, you should be able to see this node. Now if I shift alt click on this one, this is going to render the curves that we have. This is our group output at this moment. So first of all, I'm going to change the font. So I think the font I was using is this one. Now both of these words are in one line. Now to shift this second word in other line, we are going to define a text width. Let me just rotate this into vertical X direction so that the text is sort of standing, and we can reduce the line spacing to 0.5, something like this. And we can center align this. So this is the front view of the text. So we have the main text, and we are going to convert this into a geometry later on. But first, let's bring one rotate instances node. Now this is going to help us rotate each of these characters individually. Now since we will be rotating this in only Y axis, so I'm going to bring another node called combine XYZ so that we can have access to one of these axes and plug a texture in this. So let's connect this here and let's drag it down here. Now let's bring Musgrave Texture and I'm going to plug this into Y. Let's make this one into 4D texture. Let's change the scale to something around 1. Leave everything as it is. So if you see, if I scrub this number, time value, we have this rotation going on for each character. Exaggerate this effect a bit. You can bring a map range node and and play with these numbers. Now, if you look closely, when I scrub these numbers, each of these characters are rotating from the left side of the character where the character starts, like from here, here, here. So what I can do here is shift the pivot of these characters. So simply inserting a number and observing this number 0.35 worked fine for me. So now you can see instead of from the left, every character is turning from about center of the character. So before we proceed further, I'm going to bring a simple animation into this one. So let me just set timeline to 130 frames. And on the frame number one, let's exaggerate this effect a bit. So let's set one key here. And on the last keyframe, I'm going to make this one 0, 1, almost like a default position, and set key again. So this is the kind of animation you should see. All right. What I think is rotation is a bit too much here. So I can reduce it from here. Something like this. Or maybe you can add another math node simply to adjust the intensity of the texture. So this is just so that I can quickly control how much of this texture works on these characters. So it's the same thing. The next thing what we are going to do is convert this into a geometry. Let me bring a fill curve node. So there are going to be two sides of the text. One is the main front face and second is the outline. So this is our main front face of the character. For the outline, I'm going to bring one curve to mesh and bring one profile curve. So I think a circle, curve circle is going to work. Basically, we sort of need a rectangular shape. So if you make it a 4 resolution, that is basically a rectangle. Yeah, that should work. So the radius is a bit too much. 0.01 should work. And we are going to sort of stretch this in one direction. So first of all, let's bring a transform node. I'm going to turn this into 45 degrees so that this thing is straight. Let's see what's going on here. Now let's bring another transform node. And I'm going to stretch this one in a y direction, stretch for about 18. And this should add some extrusion in the text. And we can control the width of the outline if we make the rectangle. Basically, we are performing all these on the profile curve, the rectangle that we have. So if I make it wider, that's going to affect the outline. To make these corners a bit smoother, I'm going to add one fillet curve. And yeah, we just need a slight value here. Yeah, something like this. So we have the extrusion. Now if we combine this with front face, we sort of have a solid text. Now all we need to do is bring one translate instances again. Translate these slightly further. So keep in mind, these are still instances and we haven't realized these instances. So using transform node is not going to work correctly. So we want every instance's local direction. So this should work. Now just to add a bit more into animation, what I'm going to do is right before the rotate instances, our main animation, I'm going to bring one translate instances once again. And Control Shift D to duplicate this. Combine XYZ. So basically what we want is some more variation in Z direction. Yeah. So I'm going to plug the same animation right here in the Z direction so that all the characters are on different plane instead of everything on one flat line. We can actually control this with the map range. Like this, so that at the beginning of the animation we get some more depth like this. I think it's a bit too much, so I'm going to keep it really subtle. One more thing I can do is at the beginning of the animation I can increase the character spacing like this and set one key. And right at the end, we can reduce this and crunch it tightly right here. So more or less, this is done. And we can keep on checking out different variations of it. The finer tweaks can be done later on. Yeah, this looks fine actually. So the last thing I'm going to do here is bring one set material node. So we are going to apply two different materials, one for the front faces and other for the outer rim. So let's create two different materials. So just load this here, material number 2. And I think we are all set to render this out. Let's create some basic materials and talk about lighting a bit so that yeah, we can finish it up. So let's first select the material number 1, which is on the internal part. So let's hit the render preview. And I'm going to reduce these samples a bit further. All right, so can't see much at this moment. Let me just bring one HDR in environment. Let's jump to the shader editor, world editor. I'm going to bring one environment texture. And this is going to be a simple studio EXR. All right, we are going to animate this later. And for materials, for the outer outline, we can simply bring one simple bronze-like material. And let's make it metallic. We can reduce the roughness a bit. Yeah, I think that's about it for this one. Now for the main material, it's going to be a simpler one, but for the roughness, I'm going to use a texture. But first of all, let me just make it metallic for rest of the things pretty much as it is. So let's bring an image texture. So I'm using a sort of a pattern for the roughness. It's a ornamental texture. I'm going to plug this one into roughness. So right now it's not showing up in the viewport. Let me just press Ctrl T with the node wrangler enabled. This should work. Let's change this into generated. Yeah. So you can see the kind of texture I was talking about. Now all we need to do is map range this one. Something like this. Now that we have the materials, let's talk about lighting. Now for the lighting, what I have done is, if I render this one, first of all, there's a lighting. And the second thing is I have animated the main lights. So if I disable the scene lights, so all of this is coming from the HDRI that we have in the background, the studio.exr. So what I have done here is when the scene starts, I've kept the intensity of the background zero. And later on, along with the animation, this sort of the strength is increasing, the main title emerging from the dark. So this in itself isn't much. So along with this one, I have used plenty of lights here. So if I enable the scene lights. So I'll show you one by one what each of these lights are doing. Let me just disable the background. So first of all, right behind the characters, I have this one light, simple point light. And this is sort of to highlight, to sort of create a rim for these side of the characters. I didn't want to use one light, which is going to create rim for everything. That could have been a bit overpowered light. So instead of one light, I have broken it down into multiple lights. So the second light, so this light is creating rim here on these characters. So this is the second light. For the first light, I've used the bright white color, and the second light it's a variant of blue, just to add a bit of vividness in the overall thing, to add more life into this one. So second light, and the third one is right here at the front, highlighting this part of the logo. I'm keeping these lights closer to the main surface just to sort of create a bit of mystery and not revealing everything. And all of these lights are animated. At the frame zero, you can see the intensity is zero, and later on it increases. And then we have another light, which is right here. This one is to simply create another highlight at the exit of the logo right here. And the final light, this one I have kept a horizontal rectangular area light to sort of make it more readable, Wakanda. And that's it. So simple light setup I have here. And this combined with the main background light we have. Yeah, I'm happy with the results. And I could have spent some more time on the font that we have chosen here. I think it's fine for now. We can always go back and forth and change. That's the main fun part about creating this procedurally in Geometry Node Editor. You can keep on exploring fonts and the animation will stay, doesn't matter what you tweak here, it's non-destructive. And one more thing I have added here is a simple volume cube. So this cube right here is using a volume scatter material, so a bit of fog. And this I added just to create this effect, a sort of lens flare, which we see on the left. And how this is happening is, if I select the point 2 light, on this light, I have a used node. If you select any light, you see use node here. So if you click this one, it lets you access the node of the light. So in this, I have used the same Studio EXR HDRI that we have in the Blender default folder. And then I animate the coordinates of this light. So when this travels, it creates this flare when light is passing through this fog that we have here. And yes, don't forget to add camera. I'm using a simple camera with a 94mm focal length. And also, there's a depth of field going on. At the earlier animation, we have some blur going on while the camera is closer to the entire object. And later on, we see much sharper picture. So here are my render settings, if anyone interested. I think I rendered this out in 300 samples using OptiX denoiser. And that's it. One most important thing I forgot to mention. If you render this out, render image. So what's going on actually is if you bring one compositor editor here. Yeah, so this is what default render looks like. But if I bring one glare node and change this to fog glow, so wherever there's a highlight, you're going to see this glare. So this kind of looks, it looks pretty good. And maybe render out on 16-bit color depth if you're planning to tweak colors a bit in post-production. If any of you interested in rendering this out in Eevee, let me show you. So this is what your Eevee render is going to look like. Just make sure you're using the same scene lights and scene world that is being used in the final render. And in Eevee, enable the ambient occlusion, bloom just to add the glare effect that we have, and screen space reflection. And if you want, you can tweak the shaders a bit according to this renderer. So I think this looks pretty good in Eevee as well, and you pretty much have a real-time feedback of your entire animation. So play around, I'm pretty sure you'll find your own style, your own design. I like this example, and this was the very first thing that came to my mind when I was watching this movie, that this animation is so simple. We didn't have geometry node before, but now that we have these string nodes and curve nodes, it becomes so much easier. And yeah, you can keep on saving these to library and access these later, maybe create a collection of your own of different 3D typeface designs, animations. These are all reusable. That's the main benefit of using geometry node editor. I'm pretty sure if you revisit some of your favorite show titles, like let's say Stranger Things. So in Stranger Things, what's happening is instead of characters rotating, they are sort of coming together, sliding in, and it's a simple translation. So instead of rotate instances, you can use translate instances and combine it with the different methods and achieve that result. So most of the time in the title design, a lot that is holding that composition together is coming from the design, like the font that you have chosen, the right music, sound effects, and the kind of composition you're going with. If you have those things right, the animation is going to look good as well. So just simple things you need to keep in mind. So that's about it. I hope you like this tutorial. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I'm going to leave this file on Gumroad. And if you're new to geometry node, check out the geometry node, the entire playlist. And if you're new to Blender, go watch and check the introduction to Blender series in the playlist section. We are crossing 4 million views, not the subscribers. That would be quite a big leap. Thank you for tuning in. Take care. Bye-bye. And don't forget to share your version on Instagram. Tag me with InstaCrossMind. So have a great day. Bye-bye.